don't remember if he did or not. But I have a feeling he probably did. Let me check. Well, I can't check it here, actually. Never mind. Okay, well, I guess the sole silver lining in this is I should still have my skill seed, so yay? Alright, let me check and see how my characters are slated here. Okay. Well, alright, let's see. Well, I'm thinking I guess the best way to go about doing this is probably give it to, I don't know, either Angela or Yangus, but not really sure which. Well, I guess since Angelo has the least of any of the skills, let's go ahead and give it to him. And it did nothing for me, wow. Well, okay. I told you I'd give it another shot. I gave it another shot and completely just screwed up, so in that case then, I guess let's, let's go back in and save our game. And then go beat it again. I mean, I could give it another shot, but it's going to take a long while, and it's going to take well after the 3 hours, so I don't really want to do that now. I'm guessing what I would need to do then is probably for that last one. And by the way, we didn't even get to the ultimate dragon, so that's worth noting. I guess I would have to have gotten a few more levels, yeah. I figure we shouldn't have much of a problem defeating the game at level 50, so I think we'll be in good shape on that front. Especially now that we have the hero's armor and all this stuff. Level up to 90. Yeah, because that's not going to take forever. Fly to Slime Mountain. Well, actually, in my experience, the Dragon Sanctuary, or the Dragon Graveyard, has been better. Because you have a better chance of getting Metal Slimes, or of Metal King Slimes. Okay, so I'm curious. I forgot how to drive this thing. I forgot even how to... Whoops. Okay, that's fine. Okay, that's right. Okay, yeah, so we do have to refight him from the beginning, actually, so... Alright, after level 45, the level requirement is constant. Okay. Well, yeah, Fez, because... You can fight maps with metal slimes all the times. That makes it a little bit easier. Okay, now, in order to pull this off, we've got to make room in our inventory, so... Let's see, what do I need least out of each character's supply here? Probably the special medicines. Let's see... Yeah, it's kind of funny. I'm pretty much loaded for bear at this point. Isn't there a group with insects that revives metal slimes? Yes. There is, what you're thinking about is the Beelzebubs. Or the Beezebubs or whatevers. But yes, if you get them into a battle, or if you see them in a battle with a metal slime... You can kill the metal slime, and then have them, they can use Kerplunk, and that actually will revive the metal slime. And it acts as though it is a second metal slime, not as though it's the same one again. So you can grind experience that way. I have actually done that. I've only done it once, though. I've only managed to do it once. Okay, yes, 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 thank you, thank you. Okay, thanks. We know already. Yeah, I collected them all about, say, 30 hours ago, actually.
I have located that which may be this world's last hope. Now...
Oops, sorry. I didn't mean to skip that so fast.
The scepter!
The scepter of Trodane! Careful with that. It's full of hocus pocus. Don't touch it.
There is no cause for alarm. The scepter no longer harbors Rapthorn's soul. Now it holds only the souls of the seven sages. Over the passage of its long history, the truth behind this scepter has been lost. In the beginning, it was crafted by the hands of the seven sages under my instruction. And they gave it a name. They called it the Godbird Scepter. You will need it if you are to break the dark shield around Rapthorn. Only when it is broken will he become vulnerable. Only then can you fight him. I will fly you to his location. The Lord of Darkness will engage you in mortal combat.
Bum 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 bum. Never mind.
But you must endure his attacks as you pray for the power of the scepter. When the four of you pray for its power in unison, one by one, you will summon the souls of the sages to unlock the power of the orbs. I can give you no more advice. Do you understand what you must do when you face the Lord of Darkness?
Yeah, sure.
Then we cannot afford to delay this battle any longer. Are you ready?
We could enter the realm of... This is true. Yeah, that'd make it a lot easier, wouldn't it?
You must fight him now. Take the scepter.
Oh boy. Gee, where have we seen this before? Heh. Alright, so of course we have to do like we did last time and do the whole praying with the scepter stuff, so... Yay! Where is it? Yay! Can't find the darn thing. There you are. And there you be. It's unfortunate that even after having beat the game, that you have to go through this again. Just call Asura, he's good at... true. Okay. Yeah. Man, you know, it's funny how your perspective on things changes with a little more experience and a few more levels. Because I'm just sitting here after those attacks. I know when we fought him the first time, it was a pretty tough battle. I actually lost it initially on the second phase. But, yeah, now, I'm just sitting here looking at it going... Yes, Tree Jam, the maximum bird makes its appearance one last time. But I'm just sitting here thinking, man, these attacks are nothing now. I could just, and, well, of course, we'll see how well this does. But, well, that actually did hit decently. Okay. So, never mind. Yeah. Yeah, this is a healing turn. All right, in that case then, I'm hitting the panic button with... Yes, I'm going to go ahead and use Omni-Heal. Oh! Yep, look what Yangus had. I didn't even realize it. Ugh. Well... I feel stupid now. Okay, well, in that case, kabuff. Insulatal. Kabuff. And yeah, I know my armor does make a difference on this. Yeah, I know. Alright, so we should have another couple of prayer turns, I think. Because I don't see him being able to really take us down that easily. Alas. Okay. Yeah, it's... This first part of the battle is probably the least interesting one, or the less interesting one, I should say. Just because it's all the same thing all the time. Just, oh, let's pray all the time. And you, Wave of Ice, okay. Interesting. I forgot you could do that. Well, all right. Okay, let's see. Yeah, I guess it can, I guess. But yeah, once you do get leveled up, yeah, I could see where it would be not so. Okay, so I think we've got two more sages left. So I'm probably going to need to heal this turn. Or next turn, rather. And then go from there. Or you could kill Angelo. And I'll definitely need to heal. Okay, then. Well. One that really needs healing is Jessica. Okay, well, defend, I guess. No, that's fine. I wish I could have done it. Unfortunately, if I'd known I had Kerplunk, or if I'd realized I had it, I would have likely conducted the battle against the Darksteel Dragon a lot differently. Excuse me. Alright, well, now I could probably do one turn, and then I'll need to heal Hero, most notably, next turn. What I might end up doing is... just going back and getting some more levels and then seeing if I can... okay, yeah, we got one more sage. Okay, thanks for wasting your turn. Twice! All right. In that case, then, let's go ahead and finish this out. Getting some more levels and then seeing, I don't know, seeing if I can do this in terms of the dragons, I mean. At a little bit of a later date. Hmm? Ah, yeah, I could see that. And there's our final sage. Oh, come now. Actually, speaking of bonus videos, I need to be working my way forward to do the last bonus video for Tales of the Abyss.
We sages have done all that we can. Now our dear world, our future lies in your hands. Protect it well. We will be watching you. Farewell, my beloved kin. Farewell, Imperia.
Alrighty, it's on like Donkey Kong now. Yay! Okay, so, now I know this Joker can wave of ice, so we need to not waste too much time trying to buff everything. Probably gonna do a couple of turns and then an attack, just like I did with the dragons, basically. Yeah, okay. Yeah, there is that. We get to hear this music again. And yeah, I'm being a little more silent too, so that everybody can kind of take it in, I guess. Well, that... okay, I expected to get a little more tension up before he used that, but oh well. Does calling your team preserve your buffs? I'm not sure. I mean, I would expect it would. But I don't know. Okay, well, next turn, this turn is definitely a healing turn. And there goes the wave of ice. Glad I used my big attacks when I did. Well, I was going to use this turn as a healing turn anyway. Doesn't even need a chiropractor. I know, right? Okay, so let's speed everybody up again. Yeah, having Omni-Heal for this fight is just not fair. Oh, so Imperia doesn't appear in 9? That's curious. I sort of got the feeling, or sort of figured, that Imperia would appear in all of them. But I guess not. Okay, let's see. Let me go ahead and have her... No, she doesn't need a timbrel. She needs to insulate. He needs the timbrel. Although, darn it. Oh, well, at least the idea is that supposedly she's in more of them. I don't know. So maybe I shouldn't have made the statement. I know she's in Heroes. So at least she's in more than one anyway. And sorry if I hit the mic. I didn't mean to. Alright, so who are you going to put to sleep? Jessica. Okay. Well... that'll probably wake her right back up, though. Yeah. Okay. Well, that's true, yeah. Wow. Nice. So Angela's already going Super Saiyan. Good lord. Oh! 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 What timing! Oh, man. Well, that's why I tried to do this fast, but apparently not fast enough. My goodness. Best Buy might have accidentally... Oh, interesting. And who are you putting to sleep? Of course you put Hero to sleep, the one that has the most tension. So, yay. Okay, let's see. I guess go ahead and have you multi-heal. And it actually worked in time, okay. So I wonder when that would come out. And what the subject matter would be. Smash me with that arm! See if I care! Wave of ice me. I do care. Okay, let's see. Think the release date was leaked with it? Well, alright. That's more than a little interesting. And apparently we didn't need to accelerate at all, did we? Well, oh, haha. Oh, yeah, defiant laughter, eh? You think you're on top? Yeah, forget it. I'm about to eat you for lunch. Actually, you know what? Go ahead. Twin Dragon Lash, let's just go all out. March, or April 25th, okay, huh. Well, that certainly went a lot better than last time.
We done it, Gav! We only went and bleed and done it!
At last, I can finally go back and tell Bangers and Mash it's all over. And I have something to tell Alistair, too. That he was right all along. I only made it this far because I followed my heart.
Who'd have thought we'd ever manage it? Should be an interesting anecdote for the ladies.
I want my damage back.
I bet Grandad and the Orcs Princess would be having a whale of a time by now. They must be back to normal at last.
Now keep in mind the roughly first half of the ending is going to be exactly the same.
I'm half surprised the old codger ain't turned up to surprise us as usual. But even he couldn't spring up in a place like this, eh?
I transported your friends back to their homeland. Each one of you is a great hero. Yangus, Jessica, Angelo, and of course, you. I will never forget your strength and courage. You remind me of the Seven Sages. You humans never fail to surprise me. It is time to land. Your friends are eager to see you again.
I certainly hope so. Whoosh. And down to Trodane we go. Hey, Trodane, that at least for the moment is still cursed, although that's not gonna last.
Here we are. Now you can be with your friends again.
You are welcome back. I saw you all in action. My wonderful men. You were magnificent.
I ain't one of your men, Grandad.
Neither am I.
And I'm a free agent.
Of course. And I suppose you weren't magnificent either. Wise bird, a god. Are you leaving us already?
This world is in no danger now. My path leads to other worlds.
I see. Well, anyway, we are in your Wait a minute. Aren't you forgetting something? What about the princess and I, Just how long are we going to have to suffer this outrageous curse?
Well, the power of Rapthorn's curse is weakening. It will not be long now.
Really? Splendid! I feel much better for hearing that. Well, I don't know where your next destination is. But take care. Is it proper to tell a god to take care.
I am not a god, nor is my real name Imperia. These are but the names you humans have given to me. I was known by a different name in the land of my birth. There I was called Ramia. But now I must leave. Goodbye, brave humans. It has been an honor to have known you.
Bye-bye, Ramia, for the final time. And bye-bye, little birdie. You done well.
Goodbye.
Granddad, you're sparkling!
It's taken you this long to notice. A personality as rich as mine always sparkles.
Nah, I mean literally. Take a look at yourself!
Hmm?
Ooh! But you're still ugly.
I'm back to normal. Hurrah! I'm back! Finally rid of that hideously ugly guise.
But you don't look no different. You look exactly the same as before.
What did you say? Are you blind? Dazzled by my striking appearance, no doubt. Wait. This is no time for an argument. Where's the princess? Where is my beautiful Medea?
Hello, everyone.
Beloved Medea!
Yay!
At last the curse is lifted. Everything is back as it should be.
Father.
And now, of course, hey. Trodain gets to go back to its usual self. Or to its regular self, I guess. Oy. And everything somehow that broke is magically fixed, too. Basically, it turns back time.
Oh, my castle! My castle is back to its old self, too!
Yeah. Hey, Prime Minister. Good job sitting on the throne.
Trodain is restored. The glory returns. Everyone, this calls for a banquet. Prepare a feast.
Oh, really? Okay, so she did appear another dragon. Well... yeah, Dragon Warrior at that point, but Dragon Quest games. Okay. The only ones I'd played other than 8 are 1, 2, and Heroes, so... and a smidge of 4. Think that Trode looked better as a monster? Yeah, he does have a certain ogreish charm to him while he's still green that he very much lacks when he's not. No, don't get too imbibed there, princess. You've got a reputation to protect, and my god, the fish. Holy cow, cat. And it's unfortunate that Munchie couldn't transform into Grandpa with this. It would have been nice if they had a different image ready for that, but of course, you didn't want to risk accidentally giving that away with a mistaken image. I always love that shot as Angelo's about to get torched, because you see Jessica in the background ready to basically nuke him. So, yay! We win again! Here, kids, play with fire.
Only you can cause forest fires. Or it's wildfires now, I guess, but yeah.
Yay! We get to redo the epilogue again. And we still haven't taken off our armor.
Hey, hey! Long time no see, eh? I ain't seen your muck since we polished off that fat geezer. I've been playing it straight, Gov. None of that dodgy business I was up to before I met you. Yeah, I've been doing a bit of trading, you know, bits and bobs like. Been sailing round and selling stuff in all the places we went to together. This bird, mate of mine's been bugging me for ages to help her with it. So here I am. You're looking at Yengus, the important exporter now. Anyway, I heard your big news. So you're head of the palace guards then, eh? Diamond, I'm well chuffed I can help you out on your first big job and all. And it's for none other than our darling horse prince. Oh, listen to me. She ain't an horse anymore, is she? So we're escorting the princess to a wedding at Savella Cathedral, right? Oh, I don't know, though. Beats me why she's still marrying that charmless bloke. After all that's happened. Oh, yeah. Nearly forgot. I was supposed to give you a message from this old minister I saw on the way over. Seems the princess is ready to deport now. So you can go and fetch her from her room, like. I'll be waiting down in the courtyard then, eh? See you in a bit.
And I'm going to, instead of sticking around and talking to everybody like I did whenever I did this to begin with, since we've already seen the ending, I'm going to basically... Well, I wouldn't say rush it exactly, but I'm going to run through and not talk to any of the NPCs.
Ah, it's been a while. I came as soon as I heard the news. So, it seems we'll have the honor of escorting the lovely princess. I just ran into Yengus, too, same as ever. I'm a busy man, as you know. So I wasn't too thrilled at first at having to drop everything and come over. But it is good to see the old gang again. Anyway, are you really all right with this wedding going ahead? You don't have to stick around if it's too hard for you. Just do what...
Okay. I have no idea what just happened. Okay, let's see. Let me try something here. Alright. Huh. Well, guys, the ending froze up. No! Why? Yes, it looks like it did, so let me... Actually, how did I fix this the last time? Yeah, I'm not sure. I don't know why. It's not responding to anything. And it's not letting me bring up the task manager either, which is weird. Darn it. Right in the middle of the ending, too. No!
You have to do...
Oh, there we go. Okay.
Like I did when I left the Abbey.
Okay, back. Good.
Oh, Angelo's so wonderful. You know...
He looks after children who don't have anywhere else to go, don't you? He says he wants to repay all the kindness Abbot Francisco showed him when he was all alone in the world. Isn't he just the sweetest man you ever met?
We're free from the trash. Oh, boy.
Hey, no need to tell the whole world. I have a certain image to maintain with my admirers. Well, then, see you in a bit. I'll be down in the courtyard taking a break. Come and find me when you're ready.
Well, at least we get a little bit of love from that anyway. Alright, so I forget exactly where the game wants me to go. I know it'll pretty much just direct me along the path. Hey guys, how's it going? I think Jessica's over here. Or over, I believe she's over this way. Oh, never mind. Guess not. Maybe she's upstairs and over this way. I don't remember where to go. Or I don't remember how to cue everybody, basically. Oh, that's clearly not it. It is interesting, though, that they give you not really free reign of the castle, but they give you more latitude to explore the castle than I figured they would in an ending. Because typically with something like this, they'll block you from going anywhere except exactly where you're supposed to go. Well, like that. Oh, that's right. Okay.
Hey there. Long time no see. How have you been? You look pretty well, that's for sure. But how come you haven't visited me in Alexandria? I've missed you. You know, I was planning to go off and live on my own, but my mother was so worried I ended up settling down back at home.
Okay. Well, have fun. The question I'll ask everybody, actually, while the ending is going. I'm going to be doing Final Fantasy V next. So, I guess what I want to hear from you guys is, do you all want to see me playing it where I left off in the summer, or do you guys want me to restart it from the beginning, in essence?
I guess the time I spent away from her made us both realize what's truly important to us. We get on really well now. I'm not much of a replacement for my brother. But I've decided to stay and look after Alexandria. With everyone's help, of course. But enough of that. Have you heard? Apparently Yangus and Red have teamed up now and they're doing something together. Can you believe it? Last I remember, they couldn't exchange two words without three insults. I wonder what went on between them. Huh? You're on your way to pick up Princess Medea? Yeah, I guess it's time to get going. Okay then. I'll be waiting for you down in the courtyard.
Okay, so I think Medea's room is over here. I know it's not through the big room, or not the big room. Oh, yeah, there she is.
I suppose this is the last time I'll play the piano like this in here. I wonder if there'll be a piano I can play in Algonia. Thank you for coming. Is it already time to leave? I asked the minister to have you call on me so that we could take one last walk through the castle, alone together, just like old times.
Yeah, it is, but we switched over to the GBA version of the game, and then it obviously went from there. But yeah, it's that one. Because I did it for a couple of weeks in the summer, just because I was bored, mostly, and I wanted to play it. And I enjoyed it so much that, well, we're going to be playing it now, or coming up.
I know it's not quite time yet, but I wanted to say goodbye to you properly. To thank you for everything you've done. The times I've spent here in Trudaine Castle, with you, will be memories I shall treasure for always. I have to marry the Prince of Argonia to fulfill my royal duty. And you have to please continue to serve my father and protect Trudaine, just as you always have. Oh. So then, shall we go? It won't do to keep people waiting too long.
I gotta say, though, the armor does make him a little more look a little more imposing as Captain of the Guard.
So this is Savella Cathedral. What a perfect place for a grand royal wedding. Excellent work, young man. You did an admirable job of escorting us. Your duty here has now been fulfilled. You shall stay the night at the inn and return to Trudaine tomorrow.
But I thought they'd all be attending the wedding.
I'm sorry, Princess, but I'm afraid that won't be possible.
Hey, Charmless, what's up? Jerk.
Well, well, pleased to make your acquaintance indeed. I am Prince Charmley of Argonia. Goodness, you must be Princess Medea. Charmed, I'm sure. One look at you is enough to make me forget all the other beautiful girls I've ever met. I'm the luckiest man in the world to have you as my wife.
Blimey. What's with all the romance? I didn't know you had it in you, Charmless.
It's Charmley. Oh, aren't you those servants from the initiation? No doubt you're here because you heard the news of my wedding. Well, I'm afraid this is as far as you can come. I can't possibly have commoners like you at such a grand royal affair. It's not as if you're aristocracy, or wealthy, or, well, anything.
Oh, boy. So easy to dislike.
That brat is unbelievable. Can't let us in on account of our being too common, indeed. The preening little snob.
By the way, this is where the ending begins to diverge from the ending that you saw at the, well, the first time we beat the game, basically.
It's been a while since the initiation, but he is still just as obnoxious as ever. And yet tomorrow, he's going to be marrying the princess. Can you believe it? Wait a minute. The ring. You still have the ring, don't you? The one that belonged to your father. If you have it with you, go and show it to King Clavius. If he knew you were his nephew, he might just change his mind about this ridiculous marriage. Go and find him at the Lord High Priest's place and see what he says. It has to be worth a try.
Yep, you could do this as early as having the Argon Heart, or having the Argon Ring. Now, the rest of the armor certainly helps, but you could have it as early as basically when you find the Dragovian Sanctuary, even before you do any of the trials. Wow. Hey there. How's it going, Pops?
Some time ago. What brings you here tonight? You look like you have something important to tell me. That ring. It's set with an Argon Heart. How on earth did you acquire it? I must admit that your tale is enough to give even me pause. It sounds as if you truly are Eltrio's son. How else could you possibly know all the things you just told me? If my brother had not left his country behind to go after your mother, he would be king of Argonia now. And if you had been born a prince, then I suppose it would be you marrying Princess Medea tomorrow. But those are just what-ifs. It would throw the kingdom into turmoil if another heir appeared at this late hour. I cannot possibly recognize your claim. Please try not to think badly of me. You must consider the subject closed. Please leave now.
Well then, excuse me. How about you give me the ring back? I'm curious, actually. I want to check my inventory just a second. Just to see... Oh, okay, I still have it equipped. Yeah, I've still got it, but... I don't know, I was... a little curious on that front to see. Don't make me go super. I'm curious then. What am I supposed to do now? I've forgotten this ending. Yeah, well, hey, what can I say? I guess we just go out the door.
And shine, Gav. The princess will be getting itched in a bit. We've come all this way. We should at least try and get a glimpse of her all dolled up. I'll go on ahead then, eh? I'll be waiting in front of that big church.
Okay, fair enough. Alright, well... yep, so apparently Clavius won't listen to us. Great. Big surprise there. I can't really fathom, though, why, if you were to look at the...
We thought you weren't coming. The ceremony's already started. It's bedlam up there with all those people. I doubt anyone would notice you among the crowd.
Have you seen the armor I'm wearing? Yeah, I think a few folks are gonna notice me. Oh, right. Keep moving, okay. Yangus wants to see the dress. Sure. I think it was a nice dress. I don't quite recall, to be honest.
What a crowd! I can't see a thing from here!
What's going on? Has it already started?
People are saying that the bride looks stunning. I wish I was more like her.
I'm more interested in seeing the new Lord High Priest than the bride and groom, but it's impossible to see anything from here.
Congratulations, Princess Medea! Congratulations, Prince Charmels!
Hey, stop pushing! What? Oh.
There you are, Gav. I knew you'd turn up. Right, this way. Follow me.
I just want more. Yeah, some of the changes they're making to the 3DS version are pretty interesting.
Well, we've got this far. Now, we just have to take care of that knight.
Huh? Liars. Yep, I'm gonna force my way in, dang it. Bud. Plunk.
You leave him to me, Gav. Go on, in you go.
Excuse me. Now, who all... I know Mori can be in your party. I think Red can be in your party as well. Is there anybody else that's going to be sort of extra characters?
Honestly, where has the princess got to? What's taking her so long? What do you think you're doing? Are you trying to ruin my wedding? I won't stand for it. Guards, get rid of him at once.
Wait. That will not be necessary. He has a right to be at this ceremony.
Ah, here we go.
You are the rightful groom.
I love the face. Father!
Father? How can you say such a thing? I'm the rightful groom.
The rightful groom.
Yesterday evening, the boy you see standing there gave me this ring.
What's that? Is it an Argon ring? I don't understand. Only members of the royal family who've passed the initiation should have a ring like that.
This ring belonged to my elder brother. It was Eltrio's ring. That boy is his son.
Wow. That flash with the reaction.
It is only right that he should be the one to marry Princess Medea.
No! I won't allow it! Princess Medea is promised to me, so I'm the one who's going to be marrying her!
Bring it on!
Pardon me for interrupting, Your Majesty. I've just received word that the bride is now ready to make her appearance.
Open the doors! Allow the bride to enter!
What is Charmley doing? Or Charmless? I don't even know. I mean, is he trying to run away? Or what's going on here? Whee! Da-da-da-da! Da-da-da-da! Wait, that's the president. Never mind. It's a wedding! Surprise! And just like that, everything seems to be fine. So, my question then is, it says a lot when he fell for her as a horse. No, I think he liked her before the curse. And wait, we're back in our normal clothes! So, basically, yeah, they're reusing. They're reusing the same stuff as before, and it looks just as bad as it did last time. Wow. So yeah, they're reusing the same scenes from the previous ending, unfortunately. But yeah, it kind of makes me wonder if he did really marry Medea and become prince, then when Trode is gone, would that mean that he becomes basically king of the world? Because, I mean, upon the death of Trode and Clavius, he would conceivably then be king of both Trodane and Argonia. All right, guys. Badeep, 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 badeep. That's all, folks. Oh, well, now that we are coming to the end of Dragon Quest VIII, for real this time. Yeah, it was a lot of fun. Like I said before, I didn't really expect to play this through fully whenever I started. I just did it on a whim, and then people wanted me to keep playing it, so I did. And yeah, it's been a lot of fun, even with the occasional graphical issue and the freezing up in the middle of the ending and so on. But yeah, it's a good game. It's a really good game. Whenever I do get around to getting 3DS, this is a game I'll certainly be tempted to pick up. GG. Alright, thanks for tuning in, Tree Jam. Appreciate it. Next week, we will be playing Final Fantasy V. And what I'll likely do as far as whether I'm going to restart it or go from where I was is I'm going to look and see how far I was in the game in terms of my save files and such. And if I'm all that far into it, then I will start it there. Because I don't remember how long I actually played it. But if I do end up, if it ends up being something like 15 or 20 hours, then I'll start it, do it basically as an In Medias Res playthrough. For the purposes of if I decide to put it on YouTube or whatever. But if it's not all that far into it, then I'll likely just pick it back up from where I started and go from there. And basically, hopefully play it a little bit smarter this time, get a Blue Mage a lot faster, and try to get the Blue Mage skills a lot quicker, other such things. I will likely go ahead and do it as a girl power playthrough again, have the two females in the party as my strength characters, and have the two males as my mages, like I did when I was streaming it in the summer. So, that's the plan. And then, of course, Saturday and Sunday we'll be continuing on with Uncharted. And then once we get done with that, we're going to move on to Paper Mario. So Oh boy, the times, they are a-changin', or I guess the games, they are a-changin', so to speak. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it. I have, certainly. It's unfortunate that we couldn't finish it off the way I would have liked to, with going against and defeating the ultimate dragon. But I guess it's partially I didn't have enough levels, and then also partially I didn't realize I had abilities that I could have used to my benefit in that battle. So, whoopsie. I mean, it comes with the territory, I guess. But we've done just about everything in the game. I mean, we've gone up to the final battles, and we've gone to... done the ending twice. We've found most all of the monsters except one or two that opened up after the end of the game. We've beaten the monster arena. So, yeah, I mean, I'm pretty satisfied with what I did. Just unfortunate I didn't get the chance to do everything I wanted to. As for what I'm going to do with Final Fantasy V, I'm trying to decide whether I'm going to, whether I'm going to do all of the GBA content, because the GBA version of the game has extra content with an extra dungeon that opens up. I don't remember if it opens up late in the game or if it opens up after you actually beat the game. So I'm not sure if I'm going to do that or not. If I do, it'll be the first time I will have ever done that. The extra content, I mean. Because I've beaten the game, but I haven't done the GBA stuff yet. I haven't really used the GBA jobs all that much, because there are some extra jobs that you end up getting in the Game Boy Advance version of the game that you don't have in the original version. So I'm still trying to figure out what I'm going to do on that front, but I will... We'll obviously get into it as I play the game. I'm not sure if I'm going to do this, but I'm also thinking about if I end up playing through some of... I mean, heck, actually, I could do this either for Tales of the Abyss, playing through to get toward the stuff for the New Game Plus video, or I could actually maybe stream some more of 15... in the next couple of weeks while I have some extra time.
It's been a long journey.
Yes, it has.
A lot has happened along the way, but it's all worked out well in the end. How curious to think that you would have been Prince of Argonia had things been different. Fate deals strange hands indeed. Ooh, to those old promises made so many years ago. Now you two are free to decide your own destiny.
Never mind that now, Father. Look, we're home. Home for good.
Yay! Let's see, you remember the extra dungeon in Final Fantasy II. I don't think I played the extra dungeon in 2. I've watched, I think it was, I can't remember, was it Hironobu or Kulikin? I think it was Kulikin, actually, that played through the extras on Final Fantasy 1. And honestly, they looked kind of boring. I just didn't find them to be all that interesting, except for the boss segues there. Alright, so I guess that wraps it up, guys. This is it. No more Dragon Quest, period. Except maybe if I level up enough, I don't know, I might stream the going through the dragons again, but whatever. We'll consider that later. But for now, I'm going to go ahead and close things off because we're done, and it's been about 3.5 hours, as it turns out, with trying the dragons twice. But yeah, I will be continuing Uncharted on Saturday and Sunday. And I will be starting Final Fantasy V, whether in medias res or at the beginning, next Tuesday. So have fun, enjoy. I hope you guys will join me for that, and if not, then have fun. But if so, hopefully I will see you guys there, and hopefully we can have fun in however I end up playing the game. So As always, thank you guys for joining me, and I'll see y'all later.